Hey there, Ride the Car Guy here, and today I think it's high time that the Xterra get a bit of a facelift. If you're a longtime subscriber of the channel, then you know I've already painted the plastics on the Xterra, and you all made it abundantly clear that you didn't necessarily agree with the color choices that I made. And frankly, after I painted it and looking at it and driving it for a couple of months, I agree with you. It looks like it's pre-faded, so these are actually painted, and they just look like the old ones after multiple years of sun exposure. So after talking with all of you, and of course getting on the Xterra subreddit and asking for recommendations, the overwhelming response was use bed liner. So that's what I'm gonna do today. I'm gonna use black bed liner, and I'm gonna black all of the plastics out. But that's not what we're gonna focus on today. In addition to, of course, painting the plastics, today I'm also going to put a new emblem on the front, and we're gonna install a front-facing camera. I wanna shout out two people from the Xterra subreddit that gave me the inspiration for doing what we're about to do to the Xterra. First and foremost is James of Carson. I saw he did a Nissan Patrol emblem on the front of his Xterra, and I absolutely love the way that it looked, and that's why I'm doing it today. And then also we have Rivers to Rooftops. He had an awesome picture of what I think was a really well done Xterra on the subreddit, and he removed the plastic pieces on the side, and it turns out there's quite a nice, visually attractive divot underneath those obnoxious plastic pieces. I actually love the way that looks, so I'm actually gonna remove the plastic side pieces and not even repaint them. Just take them off, leave it the way it is, and clean up the paint as much as I can underneath. So all that means that I have a ton of work to do today. So we're gonna start by taking off the front grille. I'm just gonna buzz through that since I already have a video on it. I'll put it as a recommended video on the screen here, and I'll also put it down in the description below if you wanna know how to take that off. So of course, here is our grille, and you can disassemble this more than just where we're at now. If you flip it over, you'll see there's just a whole bunch of little plastic clips. And as long as you're careful, because these do get brittle over time, but as long as you're careful, you can disconnect all of the additional pieces. So basically the honeycomb separate from the frame, and then of course take the emblem off, which is what we're doing. So I'll do that here in a minute. This is the new emblem that I ordered. I got this off eBay. There is no, in my opinion, I guess no real reliable source to find these, since I had to get it off eBay from some dude up in North Carolina. But there is no Amazon link. I can't find a readily available source since these were for the Nissan Patrol, which my understanding was not offered in America. So the plan here is to take off this emblem, install this one, and as you can see, it is utterly huge. So what I'm gonna have to end up doing, possibly cut this out. I'm not exactly sure. I know in the past I've talked about not doing anything that will kind of prevent me from going back to stock. But the more I think about it, it's like 16 years old now. I'm probably its last owner, so who cares? I'm just gonna do what I want. So here's our emblem. I'm pretty sure, I'm actually gonna take this out to see, so this will be able to get closer to the grill. Well, no turning back now. I just broke the living crap out of this. Basically broke every clip getting them out. But that's my style. So there's the old one. Here is our new one. And dang, look at these giant mounting holes. I guess once we black it out, maybe it'll be a little less obvious. I'm gonna keep disassembling this because we're painting it anyways, but I'm gonna keep disassembling it to see if it's reasonable or not, honestly. So this is obviously without our plastic piece in here. So I think if I, and actually this just kind of sits in these holes here. It's kind of nice. That alone looks pretty decent. It's kind of neat. I'm gonna make a few initial markings to kind of get an idea of where it's going. So that's right there. So it's like this, like that. There we go. Went ahead and just measured. I'm gonna undercut it, of course. You should always undercut this kind of stuff. honestly, if push comes to shove, I'll just repurchase this if I really dislike it, but I think I'm gonna like it. I think it'll be pretty neat. Once it's all blacked out, this will be a lot more discreet. It won't be obvious that there's this big ring back here. And then this should hopefully just be shining through. Okay, this is turning out to be interesting, to say the least. But at this point, two things that I learned. I didn't have to cut all the way back on this. I don't think it's gonna matter, but I could have left a piece right here. Maybe, if nothing more than structural rigidity, but it still feels really strong because it has this bend here in the plastic. So also, if we flip it over, I made sure not to cut this support out. So this actually clicks into place on here on the back support. So I made sure to go above that line so we're not sacrificing this particular clip. So again, at this point, I'm just gonna grab some files and some sandpaper, get this all cleaned up, all the edges nice and clean, and then make sure this fits into it, like actually inside of it. And then we can start our painting process. And once everything's painted, we can reinstall it. This is where we landed as far as fitment. So now it is flush with the original emblem kind of backing. Here, let me push it down. There you go. So there we go. I think, honestly, once we clean up these edges, I sanded these all down. They look pretty darn good. But again, once you do like a flat black or just make everything behind this a ton darker, you're not gonna notice these big gaps in the outer grille. So next step, sand all of this down, get both of these things painted, and then see how it looks. While all this dries, I'm going to start taking the plastic off the side of the truck. Again, not really gonna cover that. It's literally just taking it off and then cleaning up the glue, but I'll just do a quick little time lapse for you on that. All right. So it's all off here, and as you can see, it has a nice divot. It actually still feels like there's something there, right? So that's what I like about it. We just need to get some more heat on here and start peeling all of this adhesive off. Okay, so the method I'm using, now that I have this peeled off and all of the actual like tape itself, so like the thick foamy tape has been removed, I'm just taking a bunch of Goo Gone, just letting it soak, going kind of scraping off a layer, grabbing Goo Gone again, letting it soak again, and kind of rinse and repeat, so to speak. I'm already getting tired of this. This is kind of awful. So the grill should be dry at this point. Let's go deal with that, and I'm gonna come back to this and I'll just show you what it looks like once I'm finished. Hey, future Ryan here. I'm back home, and I was actually watching a Wheeler Dealer episode this morning, and if you're not watching that show, what are you doing with your life? But they were removing vinyl wrap from an old Jeep Wagoneer, and he used an eraser tool on a drill to remove all the vinyl. And as soon as I saw that, I was like, oh my gosh, this is absolutely perfect. So I went and tried it. I ran over to my local auto parts store and I bought a 3M eraser wheel. And of course, I'll put a link down below for this exact wheel and a few other options that are gonna be a little bit cheaper. But this thing was $50. Yes, $50. Super expensive, but it is working absolute wonders on the remainder of this adhesive. The Goo Gone really worked great up until it got to that final layer of adhesive that was against the steel. So it was very effective in removing all of the foam and kind of the bigger chunks of adhesive. But when we got down here to the very bare metal and just the very thin layer, again, of adhesive on the end here, it got very, very difficult. This, however, is making incredibly quick work of it. So you just take this wheel, you put it on your household drill, of course, and then just lightly run it against the adhesive and it peels it right off. This is made for automotive surfaces, so it brings it right down to the paint, nice and clean, and doesn't etch into the paint at all. So highly recommended that you pick one of these up if you're looking to tackle this job, as it makes life just infinitely easier in removing that last layer of adhesive. All right, back to the video. All right, here's the new grill and the new insert. Let's see here. So obviously I went in and painted all of the honeycomb. And then here is the new and improved front fascia here. So let's slide that in place. Ooh, that looks pretty good. So once we have our emblem in here, let's tuck this into place. Being gentle, because you know the paint is not cured yet for sure. Now, that is what I was talking about. It looks pretty darn good. And honestly, if you look at it, I mean, you're obviously gonna see this. I might have to figure something out with this, but from far away, when it's on the truck and it's outside, it's gonna look pretty darn good. Comment below, what do you guys think of this? So my little mock-up here looks pretty darn good. So I'm going to figure out how to make it stay, and then I'll let you know what I did. All right, to get this permanently attached, I'm gonna actually do two things. First of all, my particular emblem came with these little studs that have these little nuts that attach to them. So theoretically, I could grab something and go behind the emblem through these mount holes, which I am going to do, but we just kind of got to get creative with that. But I'm also going to use some double-sided sticky tape right on the front face of where the old emblem was clipped in. For that, I have some double-sided sticky tape by Grille, the company that makes Grille glue, of course. And this stuff is absolutely insane. It's actually even difficult to work with just off of the roll because of how sticky it is. So what I'm gonna do is probably end up doing two layers of Grille tape where it makes sense. So on the high points here that are gonna be corresponding to the bare or flat spots here. So for me, that means just grabbing this and basically between these two studs on the high points. So probably right here and right here, I'll grab them and then stick them on, of course. Now in retrospect, I should have masked this off and left it raw so I could sand it down and get a nice keyed surface to stick the tape to. So now what I'm gonna have to do is just do a reverse mask. So mask everything I don't want to sand and just kind of gently sand this away. So you're not just sticking to paint, you're actually sticking to the plastic below. So the combination of those two things should make it pretty darn secure. Now, it wasn't a big deal to kind of mask this off and sand it, but if you're following along, just take a piece of tape and just mask this off prior to painting, and then that way you don't even have to deal with the sanding when you're done. The second part I'm gonna deal with is the studs, and the studs are gonna need a little bit more room. Right now they sit in the very upper left-hand corner of these kind of mount holes. So I'm just gonna carve these out just a little bit more just so I can kind of fit the nut over top of the stud once it's in place. My Dremel's in the other room and I'm far too lazy to go get it. So I'm just gonna try this. So the plan is, once we have that in place, and obviously once we have it stuck down, I have some polypropylene, basically hanger. It's basically meant to hang water pipes in your basement, for instance. But it's flexible and it has pre-drilled holes. So the idea is that, of course, use the stickiness on the front, but just in case something goes wrong with the stickiness, I don't want to lose the emblem. And so I'm just gonna push this over the studs on the rear and kind of create a strap on the back that's gonna hold it in place. To do that, I'm just going to set down something soft here, flip it over, there we go, and kind of space it out. Now that it's spaced out, just gotta get enough of this stuff here, probably just bend it like that, perfect, and just push it in. Yeah, I think that'll actually work. So bend it there, bend it there. So basically, again, I'm just making a little strap. I'm gonna widen these holes a little bit, push them around the studs, and then just put the nut on the stud. I'll put a link in the description down below of all the stuff that I'm using, but especially this kind of stuff in particular. So if you need it, it'll be down there. Just test fitting these. Awesome. So it's gonna go just like that on the rear and then screw it in place. What I can do is actually leave one of these alone. So leave one on and then feed it through the grill so it'll be easier for me when it comes time to actually stick it in there. So now that that's taken care of, I'm going to grab my double-sided sticky tape, get a few spots in here, build it up a little bit and get it to stick to the front of the grill. These two spots here, right by the S's, if you will, are gonna stick directly to the spots that I sanded down. So this has kind of the hole in the center of the grill, so that's not gonna do anything. And then over here is a little too low. So I'm just gonna stick with these two, build up a couple layers with this Grille tape, and then go stick it in place. Awesome, so I have my tape in place. Hopefully you can see that. And then we're just gonna go slide in one of these two. There we go. Flip that over to the side. And then we're gonna go feed this in. We're gonna put this in the grill, push it in place, put our nuts in, and all will be well. Huh, interesting. This appears that it needs to be put on from the back. It's too wide to properly fit in here. So we're just gonna stick this in first. Oh, all right. So it's stuck in place. Let's go ahead and flip it over and push on our little plastic pieces. Perfect. Let's go ahead and push that on. Awesome. There we go, there is one. Excellent. Strap is in place. Feels pretty darn tight. Let's take a look at the front here. Hey, hey. And that is rock solid. So hopefully that strap holds in place. This entire thing is just plastic. So those studs aren't exactly super strong, but right now, it's looking pretty good. Now on to painting the rest of the car to match this fresh looking grill. Now that the grill is looking pretty darn good, it's all nice and dry and the emblem's put on, I'm gonna focus on painting the rest of the plastics. Now again, I already have a video for this. I painted all the plastics and did all of my steps. Here's what I'm gonna do differently this time. I'm not gonna remove any of the plastics from the car. I'm just gonna go ahead and mask everything and paint it without taking it off. The only thing that I did pop off, which was of course the grill, which you already saw, but also I took the step panel off of the back bumper, and that way it's just easy. You literally just lift it with your fingers, so why not? And then I masked off everything else, and I'm just gonna go ahead and sand it and paint it while it's still on the truck. Also, where you see exposed bolts, I just went ahead and pulled those off too. It's just gonna be a lot cleaner experience when you get that all painted. And then obviously put those nuts back in. It looks like they weren't just painted over lazily. Once that's done, we're gonna go install the front facing camera that I'm super excited to install. That was a ton of work, but look at the result. I absolutely love the way that this paint turned out. I love the texture that the bed liner gives. Of course, the dark color makes it look a ton newer, and we have our new Nissan badge installed. The rear looks just as good. I'm very, very happy with the result. I decided to paint the whole thing black, including the metal bumper and that little step pad. The sides, however, are not faring as well. They look okay right now, but up close you'll see a lot of adhesive still left on it. I spent hours trying to get the adhesive off, and it's just taking forever. Layers of goo gone, scraping, goo gone, scraping, etc. And that's all right. Once I get it fully done and get everything kind of exactly where I want it, I'll do a community post to show you updated progress pics on the side and of course the rest of the plastics, just the full facelift, if you will. Until then, however, let's proceed. Let's get the front camera installed and then we'll wrap up the video. Now that the paint is done and looking, in my opinion, pretty fantastic, we're gonna move on to installing the front view camera. To gain access, I took the grille back off, and before I ever painted this, I drilled a hole exactly where I wanted to mount the front camera. I drilled it in at the bottom of the sort of top support here, and I bought a camera that's meant to be mounted upside down. Effectively, it's just on a little stud, and the idea is that you're going to screw it into the bumper, support it with a little nut, and then your camera will be sitting just like this, ready to look at the road ahead. Now, when I drilled the hole, I drilled it just a little too small. And of course, these are threaded, so we're still gonna put a nut on here for support, but I'm gonna be able to push into the plastic and sort of thread the plastic too. So between that and the nut, this thing is not gonna go anywhere once it's installed. Now, to get these mounted, I'm gonna take my cable and route it through that hole. There we go. Pull it all the way through. And then as we get up to the camera itself, just start spinning it inside of that hole. And I actually already did this earlier, so it's already threaded, but you would have to push a little bit harder to get the thread started. And then once they do, you are good to go. Just spin it all the way up till it's flush against the bumper. That feels great. Okay, so that's nice and tight up against the plastic. And then as an added measure, it comes with a nut that you would grab and just, of course, slide on here, route it down, and then get it to screw on to the stud and tighten it down. Now, before I go too crazy on this, they do supply some little wedges, like shims, if you will, that if you do decide that this is too aggressive, either too far down or too high up, they do supply some of those, again, those little shims that you can put in between the bumper and the camera itself. I'm gonna kind of tentatively plug all this stuff in, see how it looks, and then once I'm ready, I can kind of commit. So I'm gonna droop this down a little bit and run it to probably, let's see here. There's a little gap in this fan shroud here. Run it up here, probably through the headlight. There you go, behind the headlight there. And then behind the battery, and then of course we'll kind of throw it, let's route it behind the radiator fluid reservoir here. Hold on. There's a few places in here. There's like a big loom here, and there's a place back here on the hose. If you wanted to, you could zip tie this, of course, once you get everything in place, just cinch it all down. Here's the other end of my cable. And to get the other end of my cable through the firewall, I actually drilled a hole. Now, there's gonna be a couple places, if you work real hard, you can find where you can actually get through a grommet. But a long time ago, I drilled a hole for my amplifier cable. And so I just, right next to it, drilled another hole. And I'm just gonna take a little protective loom and do what I did with that cable and just protect it, slide it through that hole so it doesn't chafe against that freshly cut metal. And then that's it. I just plug these two in, and I'll probably grab some shrink wrap or something to finalize this once we see that everything looks good. But for now, I'm gonna plug this in, let this sit, and then of course we can tuck it all in and do all of our cable management when we're ready. But for now, let's go get it wired up to the radio and see how it looks. I went ahead and disconnected the negative battery cable so that way we don't break anything. So I'm gonna disconnect this, pull out the radio frame here. Normally you'd have a screw that you need to unscrew here, but I broke the bracket, so yeehaw. I have a full radio install video if you wanna kind of see a much more in-depth look at how to install a radio in the Xterra. But for now, I'm just gonna go ahead and buzz through this. Now, as you can see, this radio handles quite a few things here. So I'm gonna try to wipe out, well, really everything. I'm just gonna disconnect everything to make it easier so I'm not sitting here holding it the whole time. Now my radio is a Kenwood Exelon DMX 907S, and this will handle up to, I believe, 4 cameras. And if you're interested in this radio, of course, I have a review on it on my second channel, so that'll be a recommended video. But this actually will supply the camera with its power. So it says here, camera plus and camera negative. So I'm just gonna pop these off, these little connectors, because they're kind of specific for probably a Kenwood camera. So I'm gonna cut these off, strip them, hook them up to the positive and negative from the wire that came in from the camera. That wire is here, came in again with the main cable that we just routed through the firewall. And this will reach all the way to the back of the radio from the firewall. So I'm just gonna run it up here and then connect it to these two. Awesome, I pulled these through behind the glove box. If you are having trouble feeding them, luckily in the Xterra, once you have the radio out, you can actually get your hand back here and just pop out your glove box. And if you push the sides, the whole glove box will actually fall forward and you can kind of work your way through that way. It's pretty simple once you do it once. So I have my cables here, my positive and my negative. I'm gonna take, again, the positive and negative from my radio, pop those off, strip them out. I like to use butt connectors, so I'm gonna slide these in here and then clamp it. One side done, just gonna do the negative, and then we're ready to rock. Awesome, our connections are made. They're looking pretty clean here. And now that's it. We can just go back in, plug in our, of course, our video in to the back of the radio. This is a trigger wire, so this is something that would be designed if your radio had to use a trigger to turn on the camera. So I'm not gonna use that. So I'm gonna tape that up, reconnect everything, and then just kind of place it back in, not button everything up because, well, if it doesn't work, we need to figure out why, and it's easier to do that without all the stuff in here. Awesome, I'm gonna go throw the negative cable back on. I'm also gonna plug these back in because your little airbag light will freak out and it will actually set off your airbag warning light if you don't have it plugged back in. So I'm just gonna throw these back in to make sure that all that is in good shape. There we go, perfect. Negative cable. Then back in here to test it out. Here we go. Grab this. Parking guidelines, front camera settings. And go back here, finish. Pause that, menu, setup. Can't seem to get it running. I'm gonna have to check out my manual and see what's going on, but I'll let you know what happens. So it turns out that the positive and negative cables that I used were for a specific Kenwood camera. So I have to go pull that positive and negative cable off and go figure out a different place to wire them up. But I already have something in mind. Where I brought the cable through the firewall is right behind the fuse panel. So in there, I can just slave off of a particular fuse and just hook up the power there. And so that way the camera's just always running when the car is running. Not all is lost, however, because I did have to come back here to plug in the video cable anyway, so it's not like this was all for naught. So I pulled the power cables back, and I'm gonna wire this back up, and then we're gonna go supply power to the camera elsewhere. If you wanted to, during this testing phase, you can just go take the power cables directly from the camera and just put them straight on the battery terminals just to make sure you have power and then test it, or you can do it the way I'm doing it and kind of do a little bit of trial and error. Either way, get it wired up, we'll test it again. I'm gonna take power from one of my existing line taps. I kind of have a lot going on here, so I wanna minimize. And we have the rear view the rear view mirror on one of these. So I'm just gonna take this off and it's gonna share it. So just pull it through. Actually, I can pull it backwards if I want. Probably make it a little easier. There we go. And I'm just gonna connect it along with this in here and then plug it back in and it should be good to go. As far as the ground, you can find a ground anywhere in your engine compartment. Just ground it there or ground it the back of your radio, ground it wherever you'd like to do it. Let's give this one more try. I put the negative battery cable back on. So if you go to the camera assignment settings in this particular radio, it says rear view camera, front view camera, third view camera, audio video in, all kinds of stuff. But if you click on front view camera, it finds the feed. So there we go. We know it's working now. And we can see, hit enter here. And then now when we go back to camera, there you go. Awesome. So actually what that means is we could have had it working already. I just didn't know. The manual says nothing about doing camera assignment, but it's possible that the positive and negative camera from the rear of the radio could have worked, but it's working. So let's just button everything back up, finalize our wiring under the hood, and we are done. Now, before we wrap this up, there's a few little cables here that are kind of poking out of the main line, and these actually deactivate certain things. So for instance, if you wanted to take away the guidelines on the video, you can cut the green wire, which I'm going to do. The purple wire will invert the image. So basically if you were mounting it in a hanging position, but if you flipped it and you were mounting it in a sitting position, you'd cut that cable to flip the image. And then it says for a front view camera to cut the white wire. I'm assuming that's gonna actually invert the image because I noticed that the image is backwards when looking at it. So I'm actually gonna cut the white and the green. And now the guideline should go away and the image should be flipped back to the right orientation. Once you have those severed, I'm gonna disconnect this and I'm gonna shrink wrap these so it is protected from the elements, and then probably just electrical tape this and then zip tie it along the way, and we are ready to rock. Awesome, that feels good. Plug this in, there we go. So I'm just gonna tape that up and again, just zip tie along the way to tuck everything up. Well, it was an incredibly long day, but it was so worth it. I don't think it could have turned out any better. I love the way the plastics look and I love my new front-facing camera. The new emblem will hopefully make a statement. I think it looks really good. I still have some work to do on the side here. There's a lot of adhesive left, but I am honestly just done for the day. So I need to go home, take a rest, and maybe take a look at this tomorrow. Like I said earlier, once I get the sides all cleaned up, I'm gonna wash it, I'll detail it, I'll get it all nice and pretty, and then I'll be sure to do a community post with some photos on how it looks. Comment down below, what do you think of the new color, the new emblem, and the new front-facing camera? Is that something you would ever use? As always, down below in the description is the links to all of the products that I use today. If you have any questions, also make sure to comment and ask those. Also, make sure you're subscribed for more awesome Xterra content. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.